Sturgill Simpson presents Sound and Fury as a musically driven anthology of anime vignettes accompanying the album Sound and Fury by artist Sturgill Simpson. There is good animation in this, but it's all in the trailer. Stop after you watch that, you've seen all this has to offer. The music is good, it's very good, but there's no synchronization between it and the visuals as far as I can tell. I don't particularly listen to the lyrics of songs, music videos especially, but I couldn't hear anything in the content which suggested there was any correlation between what I was seeing and what I was hearing. Any random album or music would have fit in the background of this animation with the same, if not a better, result. The animation itself borders on webtoon quality at times, which is massively disappointing for what is essentially an OVA or an anthology. That's not to disparage webcomic creators, who usually work on passion projects as part of a small team or single illustrator, but rather an indictment on the quality within Sound and Fury, which has the backing of several studios and animators. Approximately 3/4 of this 40-minute work is animated, so you feel they could have put in a bit more effort. The cel-shaded stuff is pretty ordinary, on par with other works by Netflix anime productions such as Knights of Cydonia. However, you could slightly forgive those projects which have to produce several episodes worth of content with a limited budget. Sound and Fury has no such excuse. The rest of it is barely worth mentioning as either of laughable quality or far too abstract to rate. Just skip this. The trailer is extremely misleading, presenting itself as a stylized and exhilarating ride through an animated soundscape. Instead, we get crowdfunded level production values and a complete divorce of Sound and Fury.